Paul Pierce is one of the greatest small forwards to ever play the game of basketball. With career averages of 20 points, 6 rebounds, and 4 assists per game, he helped guide the way to the Boston Celtics championship back in the 2007-2008 season. Since retiring, the truth has been known for strong opinions about how he compares to other NBA players. And recently, Pierce said that he was a better player than Dwyane Wade, and that if he would have played with LeBron and Bosh back in the day, he would have won a ton of championships. So for this video, we are going to go back to the 2010-2011 NBA season when LeBron James first signed with the Miami Heat, and we are going to replace Wade with Paul Pierce to see how he would finish up his NBA career. So here we go, guys, the 2010-2011 NBA season. Let me know in the comment section below, guys. I need to know straight up. Do you feel like Paul Pierce or Dwyane Wade is the better player? I'm pretty sure I know what the answer to this question is. But, you know, if there's people thinking on the side of the truth, I definitely want to hear your comments, in the comment section below. So, as far as the lineup going into this first season, we have Mario Chalmers, Paul Pierce, LeBron, Chris Bosh, and Big Z. I was thinking with Bosh at center, but at this point in the NBA, you know, a lot of people were still running the traditional lineups out there. So Paul Pierce, I think to keep things completely transparent, we want to keep him at shooting guard because that is the position that Dwyane Wade also played for the Miami Heat. Of course, here is the rest of the lineup right here. So yeah, guys, we are just going to simulate this first season like normal. Then I am going to go ahead and simulate the rest of his NBA career until his retirement. You know, I think it was about 7, 8, 9 years later. He didn't spend the entire time with the Boston Celtics. He ended up, you know, playing for the Brooklyn Nets and also the Washington Wizards. I believe the Clippers also. But yeah, man, let's simulate this first season with Paul Pierce as shooting guard. And just so you guys know, looking at the rosters over here for the Celtics, we do have Dwyane Wade at the shooting guard position. He's at a 97 overall at the age of 28. You know, we had to put Ray Allen as small forward. So we'll see how that goes for that lineup. But yeah, man, let's go ahead and simulate this and see what Paul Pierce can do on the Heat. Okay, so they have a record of 16-21, one more game against the Brooklyn Nets right here, finished with a W on the regular season. So MVP, we got LeBron James again. That no surprise there, 28 points, 9 rebounds, 10 assists for him. John Wall, Rookie of the Year, Manu Ginobili, 6-man Dwight Defensive Player, Carmelo Most Improved, and Eric Spatula as Coach of the Year, All-NBA First Team. So we got Wade making this on the Boston Celtics. So Paul Pierce started making that All-NBA first team on the Boston Celtics. I'm not quite sure about that one. I know he's made the All-NBA teams, I believe. Then we got LeBron right there. All-NBA second, looking like this. And All-NBA third with Rondo of the Boston Celtics on there. Let's go ahead and check out these playoffs. So we do have Miami is the second seed. Boston is the third seed. So chances are these teams do meet in the second round. Let's go ahead and check out these player stats here real quick here before we do all that. So LeBron, 28 points. Yeah, we know his stat line. So Paul Pierce, 24 points, 6 rebounds, 6 assists, being the second option of the team. I will say that, yes, Paul is like an isolation type of player, likes the ball in his hands. But at the same time, man, like his 3-point shooting was definitely better than Dwyane Wade. So he might have actually been a better fit in some circumstances over D Wade. And we got Bosh at 16 points right there. There is the rest of the team. Let's go check out D Wade on the Celtics. So we had 22 points, 5 rebounds, 9 assists. So a lot more balancing scoring on this team. Ray Allen at 19 points at the small forward position. And then again, it's like Rondo and Wade in the backcourt. Those are kind of like similar-esque players where just like the style of play they do. So I don't know if that would be the optimal choice either, man. But, you know, still put up nice numbers. Still got that All-NBA first. All right, so first round. Let's simulate this for both sides and see what happens right here. And it looks like, yeah, both these teams are going to be meeting. We have the Miami Heat sweeping, and we have the Boston Celtics winning 4-1. Let's go ahead and simulate. We'll do this one game by game right here, man, see if it goes down to the wire. So we got that. Next up, we got 1 game apiece. All right, all right. 2-1. We got tied series, man. Tied series. Next one up, we got 3-2. Let's simulate with Simcast right here. And see which of these two teams wins this crucial game 6. Looks like it might be the... Ooh, I don't know, man. The Heat are kind of bouncing back. And, well, there we go, man. 113-99. They are moving on with Paul Pierce over the Boston Celtics. 36-6-5. That is the truth. That is the truth. 34 for LeBron. All right. Simulate this current round right here so we can get to the conference finals. So we got Miami versus the Hawks. If I remember correctly, yeah, this Hawks team was really good. You got... Josh Smith, Joe Johnson, I believe Jamal Crawford, Al Horford. So, yeah, very good team over there. And then we got the Clippers and Dallas Mavericks. So, let's simulate this one and see what happens here. And it looks like the Miami Heat are going to the finals with Paul Pierce and LeBron James. 32 right there, 8-5 for LeBron, 28 for Paul Pierce. And we do have the Clippers, man, the Clippers in the NBA Finals. So, yeah, that definitely threw some things off here because that team was not in the finals, if I remember correctly. All right, let's take this game by game again. Game one, simulate game two. Okay, tied one game apiece. We got 2-1, 3-1. Let's go ahead and simulate with Simcast on this. And it looks like the Miami Heat are going to be NBA champions, guys. Let's go ahead here, man, and jump into the end of the game and check out that celebration. Okay, so let me just point out that this is the most jacked up lineup I've ever seen in a game before. We have Chris Bosh at small forward, Eric Dampier at power forward, Paul Pierce playing point guard apparently. So Udonis has him at shooting guard. I don't know about that one, Chief. Yeah, Eric Gordon, that's the shooting guard right there for you. But yeah, man, I guess we'll just finish this game up looking like this. Paul Pierce playing point guard, but he's like, this is my team. 39-8 in this closeout game here. Okay, Big Z, here we go. Here we go. Oh, that's the truth, man. That's the truth. Knock it down, baby. There it is. 32-9-8. He's just like, yo, what's up, man? Where's the foul? Although nobody touched him. All the Heat fans out there with the white t-shirts. The white out. It's a white out. Eric Gordon doesn't know what to do. Although at this point, what can you do? Blake Griffin knocking that down. Yeah, that was before he actually knew how to shoot a basketball. Now he's actually like a freaking sharpshooter for the Pistons. All right. Yo, what do we got? What do we got? What do we got? Send me that pick roll. Come on. There's 17 centers in the game. Please, oh my, really? Really, Paul? Not the ideal way to end this one up. But yeah, I do want to see the celebration, so let's get to that. We got DeAndre Jordan calling the play. You're gonna need a 40-pointer here to get this W. And even that, man, even that. Yeah, they're gonna dribble it out. There we go, guys. First season, we have the championship. Miami Heat with Paul Pierce. They're all going crazy. Baron Davis can't believe it. He can't believe it. Look at Paul getting hyped with the team out there, man. My old Chalmers, like, get me in this too, man. Chris Bosh is nowhere to be found. 2019 NBA champions. Oh, look at that hug. Look at that. That's love. That is pure love right there for Mario Chalmers and Paul Pierce. He's so excited. Finals champions, guys. Does this prove it? I mean, it's one season, though, man. This man did say multiple championships. You know, between now and then, so, you know, he's got to go out there. What if he gets finals MVP? Okay, we got LeBron holding the trophy. I see that. Holding the finals MVP trophy. No, I'm sorry, the regular trophy. And also the finals MVP, as he should. But okay, guys, what I am going to do next here is I am going to simulate the rest of his NBA career. And we're going to go over the stats and everything like that to see what it's all about. So here we are, the 2016-2017 NBA playoffs. This is the final season of Paul Pierce before he did retire. And surprisingly enough, man, the Miami Heat, they actually kept their own. Like, they did a fantastic job rebuilding while he got older. Of course, LeBron James ended up going to the Cleveland Cavaliers. Chris Bosh had to retire due to, you know, health concerns. But, I mean, this team ended up getting John Wall eventually. Joe Henderson really came into his own. You know, he was once a member of the Charlotte Bobcats. Always good scoring, man, but really came to his own as the starting shooting guard. Paul Pierce went from shooting guard to the starting small forward throughout his entire NBA career. They also got Paul Millsap and DeAndre Jordan. Now, the bench unit, we got Eric Maynor, who actually used to play for the OKC Thunder, I believe. Timothy Mozgov somehow developed to be an 85 overall. The 2K simulation was definitely in his favor. Yeah, man, I will say the simulation, when you go like this deep into it, some of the ratings do get kind of like messed up and things like that. I mean, Zhao Key should be a 99 overall. We all know that. But yeah, man, so I thought we would go ahead, simulate this final playoff season, and then just kind of go through some of the stats for Paul Pierce and what he accomplished. You know, what is it, about 8-9 years now here with the Miami Heat, as we went through all these years, and it looks like they are going to lose first round to the Pacers. And I will say, man, from what I was seeing, that is no surprise to me. The Miami Heat, they got to the playoffs every single season, but that's exactly what happened is they always were like close, but no cigar, which is kind of like the same case with the Boston Celtics, where they won the one championship, just like Paul Pierce in this case, won the one championship, had some nice runs. We got the Hornets, though, win the NBA championship. Monte Ellis, is he greater than Stephen Curry, guys? Remember when the Warrior fans were considering, I guess when the management was considering trading Monte or Stephen Curry, like which one they were going to keep? Yeah, that was all crazy. But let's go over here to the, where are we at, man? The league news. We are going to go to the NBA record. So looking at all this, man, total points, you know, like nothing really changed all that much with his, you know, I mean, you still got Ray Allen doing his thing. Stephen Curry ended up passing him in 3-point shots. No big changes right there. Let's go to league history, I believe. Sorry, I don't really use this all that often. Looking at the MVP award, you got LeBron James, you know, winning it back in the day on the Heat. But then after that, Chris Paul just took over the entire damn NBA, staying with the Pelicans. He won it for five straight seasons, guys. Looking at the past champions, of course, we have the one season here. Yeah, I guess it was like seven seasons here with Paul Pierce on the Miami Heat. But we won the one championship. Next season, got the Spurs winning it over the Hawks, Pelicans over the Bucks. So they never returned to the finals. That's even with LeBron James, because eventually he did join the Cleveland Cavaliers. And yeah, the team still didn't really find any success out there. I mean, you can even look at LeBron, though. Like, LeBron, him with Wade, you know, with his great friend out there, with Chris Bosh, they got stuff done, but he never really had any more additional success either. So that's what the league history is looking like. Let's go to the player stats on the season. So you can see him right here. We do have him at about 14 points and 6 assists in his final NBA season. So how does this compare? Well, let me go pull it up over here on my end, man. His final season, he did average just 3 points per game. He only played 25 games. So he was able to prolong his NBA career with the Miami Heat. But overall, looking at things as a total, always a damn good scorer. Like, yeah, obviously early on was his prime years, you know, 24 points per game, 6 assists right here. But after that, man, he had one down year in this season, then bounced back for 22 points. You could definitely see it start trailing off towards the end. You know, come to playoff time, he was just worn out. But always a very good three-point shooter for the squad. Just did not really lead to success here, man. So anything else we can look at with Paul Pierce? Looking at his trophies and stuff. NBA championship, won the 2008 one, of course, with the Boston Celtics. Then the next one with the Miami Heat. Sorry, the dates are all kind of screwed up there. As far as the All-Star team, you know, consistently made that. The All-NBA teams, he made it the one season with the championship year. No, actually, I'm sorry, that's 2009 year. So he didn't even make it the championship year, man. So overall, what can I say about Paul Pierce over Dwyane Wade? Well, I guess we should actually go check out D-Wade on the Celtics, too. See what he's doing these days. While we're at it, I mean, I guess it's like a double video, you know, seeing them switch spots out there. But I didn't see the Celtics winning the championships, I don't believe. But yeah, he was still the leading scorer. At this point, he's only 35 years old, so he's got a few more seasons left before he decides to go on his little retirement. But yeah, he won all his championships. Won the 2012, 2013. Yeah, that was, of course, classified with the Miami Heat. That's why it's a little screwy going this far into the future with the teams like this, man. Because it all looks crazy like this. But yeah, continued to make the all-defensive team. Did that for 4 straight seasons. All-third team for 2 seasons. All-second team, he did that for 1 year in the simulation. And all-first team for 2 years in the simulation. Of course, made the all-star team. So yeah, I think he probably had the more successful career still overall over on the Boston Celtics compared to Paul Pierce. I mean, look at the scoring. He was obviously the number one scoring person out there. Even his three-point shot, look at this season, man, 43% from 3. So that's it, guys. That is the simulation of Paul Pierce on the Miami Heat. Led to one championship, just like the one he got in real life. Hope you guys all enjoyed. If you don't mind dropping that like, subscribing if you are new to the channel. Let me know if you want me to do some more videos like this. You know, of course, it's like a new series here to my channel, so I'm still learning the ropes, but let me